Hey guys, so let's start from what we left yesterday. Actually, yesterday we started with constructors, and constructors are of type normal constructor, then what? Then actually default constructor is also there. So default constructor, what else? Empty constructor, then parameterized constructors, and one more, parameterized constructor with this operator. Parameterized constructor with this operator. Okay, so there is one more constructor that is left, and it is copy constructor. Okay. So what is copy constructor? So copy constructors, it's something that helps you to copy one object into another object. Okay, so let me just show you how to do that. So let's open the IntelliJ IDEA. Okay. Till the time it is getting open, we will start writing a code for it. So let's say class, some class name ABC. Inside it, we will have some data members like int A, then character C, then let's say load D, and say string str. Okay, so these are few data members, and let's also have a display method of it. So display, void display, and inside it I will write the display statements for each and every data member. So let us see. Yes, it is open. So let's open the project here, and here it is. Okay, so so let me just create one class here. So I already have some package, so class and constructor, let's say copy constructor demo. Okay, copy constructor demo, and inside it I'll write these things that I already have here, and another class. There are four data members, right? So here it is. So the data members are defined here, and the display method is also here. So let's copy this. Yes, here it is, the display method. Now what I'll do is, let's say public static void main, and let's create an object of this class. So copy constructor, let's say ob is equal to new copy constructor demo. Yes, and now let's set this object with some values, that is the corresponding data members of it. So ob.a is equal to, let's say, 12, ob.d is equal to 12.3, then ob.c is equal to, let's say, since it is a character, let's put a character here, so into the single inverted comma, then ob.str is equal to, into double inverted commas, some string. Let's say x, y, z, some string is there. Yes, Now let's give a call to the display method. So b dot display, and let's run this program. So right click and run. Okay, so let's see what output it gives us. Yes, here is the output of the display method, right? So now let me just create one more object of the same class. Okay, I'll name it as ob1, and now I'll call the ob.display. So this is the display method. Now let's run this again. So now it should be ob1.display. Let's stop and rerun it again. Stop this and rerun it again. Okay, so I've created the object of ob1, so ob1.display it should do. So look at this. So the data members here are displayed, and the data members of the another class are displayed here, right? And here 0, 0.0, blank and null. Since we have not set anything to the object 1, so the nothing is stored here, and so 0, 0, 0.0, blank and null. These are the value are printed. Fine. So what I want to do is I want to copy this object into the ob1, right? So let's see how to do that. So we have to create a copy constructor here. So so constructor will be written like this, with the same name as that of a class name. It has no return type, and inside it there has to be something. Okay, and let me just pass the object of the same class. Here it is, obj. I'll give some different name. Now this has started giving me error, because this is a normal constructor call to the normal constructor should go. So for that I should have a constructor that takes no arguments, right? So what I'll do is I'll create an empty constructor just to support the first object. Okay, so the empty constructor is created here, and now it's fine. So what I'll do is to the current object, that is the data members are, that is having the data members A, D, C, and str, I'll pass the values of the object to be passed. Okay, and I can do it in this way. So A is equal to obj dot A, then D is equal to obj dot D, then C is equal to obj dot C. Okay, and str is equal to obj dot str. Okay, so now look at this. Now what we will do, in the second object, while creating the second object, what we will do is we'll pass this object, that is ob. Okay, so what will happen because of this? Now while creating the object ob1, the call to this constructor will be gone, right? And accordingly, when the ob is passed here, ob is associated with these values. So these values will come along with the ob, and let's say obj.a it is actually having 12, then obj.d will actually having 12.3, then n and xyz and so on, so like this. So now that I have passed this object into the copy constructor, and now let's run this. Look at this. Yes, you can see the ob1 is having exactly same values as that of the ob. So in this way we have copied the object ob into ob1, and with the help of copy constructor. Okay, so this is all about the copy constructor. So now let's move to the next topic, and the next topic is the access modifiers. So how many access modifiers are there? Access modifiers. Okay, so there are total four types of access modifiers. One is default, then public, then private. Third one is actually private. Fourth one is protected. Okay, so default, public, private, and protected. Now let's see. Actually, access modifier specifies the accessibility or visibility of individual data member or member function. So to understand this practically, we are going to do one activity, and that activity will be like this. MS Paint. It will be quite like this. Sorry. What we are going to do is we are going to create two packages. Okay. So let's say this is a pack one and this is the pack two. Okay. So in these two packages, we are going to create one Java file each. So I'll call this as a Java 1, then this is Java 2, then this is Java 3, then this is Java 4, right? And in each class I'm going to write some code, and that code would be something like this. Okay, so let me just copy some old code. I'll just keep the necessary things and we'll remove the other part of it. So here it is. So this is the code. Now I don't want this either. Yes. Okay, so if suppose this is let's say class Java 1. Okay, if suppose this is a class Java 1, and let me just copy the same. Yeah, so that it will look quite better. Yes, so this is a class if suppose Java 1. In case if it is a Java 1, put the postfix 1 in front of every data member as well as the member function. Okay, so this kind of code you have to write in each and every class. Okay, so like this. Right, just there will be a change if it is 1 here, Java 1, then put 1, 1, 1, 1. Also there should be 1 here as well. Okay, so let it, we will take care of this while creating the program. So so this is the thing that you have to create, right? So let me just do it. Okay. So right click, new, let's say pack one, and let me just create one more package. So say pack two. Okay, and inside each pack there will be a Java class, let's say java one, and then also it will be one more class Java 2. In the another package, let's create two more classes, Java 3, and one more class as Java 4. Okay, so now let's do the same activity, same thing. I should print here और लेट्स पिक अप सम वैल्यूज फ्रॉम हियर. सो वंस आई क्रिएट अ क्लास जावा वन प्रॉपरली लाइक दिस. यस सो हियर इट इज. आई डोंट नीड अ कंस्ट्रक्टर हियर एक्चुअली. I just need public static void main. Yes. So now, as this is Java 1, so A1, D1, C1, STR1. Similarly here A1, D1, C1 and STR1. Okay. Similarly, let's have the same data in every class, but just we will change the postfix of it. So since it is a Java 2, so A2, D2. Then C2, STR2, display 2, here also A2, D2, C2, STR2. So let's copy the same thing in Java 3 as well. So in Java 3, here it is A3, D3, C3, STR3, A3, D3, C3. STR3, also the display 3, right? Here also we have changed. Here we need to change it to display 1. Okay, and the last class, so A4, D4, C4, STR4, A4, D4, C4, STR4, display 1. Okay, so now let's start from Java 1. So just create an object of Java 1. Here I'll be creating a object of Java 1. So Java 1, let's say ob is equal to new Java 1. Okay, so now let me just put some values to ob dot, let's say a1 is equal to 12. Let's say ob dot D1 is equal to 12.3. Then I can also access ob.display1, my own method. Okay, so here you can observe that I can access the data members here comfortably. Now just observe, we have not specified the access modifier in front of any data member. So the access modifier here is default. Okay. Default is when you don't specify the access modifiers. Okay, and the next point is default members are accessed where. So we are going to see where we have the visibility of default members. So look at this. In the same class, I can access the default members comfortably. Let's try this in another class. You can comfortably create the object of any class into any other class as well. So Java 2, I'm creating here the object. So Java 1 OB is equal to new Java 1. Okay, so I've created this object inside the Java 2 class. So look at this. So ob dot a1 is equal to some value. I can comfortably set a value of a1 here. Then ob dot let's say c1, right? So it actually proves that default members can be accessed outside the class as well. But observe carefully, we are in a same package. Now Java 1 and Java 2 are inside the same package. Let's try this outside the package, another class outside the package. So here Java 1 OB is equal to new Java 1, and let's try to access the OB dot A1 here is equal to 90. And what is this? Here you observe, It says that A1 is public in pack1.java1 cannot be accessed from outside the package. So default members cannot be accessed from outside the package, right? So default members, let me just write, default members can be accessed, default members can be accessed first within the same class, then in another class in same package, and third thing, not in another class in another package. Okay, so this is about the default member. And now let's see public. What is public? Look at this. If this A1, if I make it a public, then what is happening? The error is gone, right? So public members can be accessible outside the package as well. Now the same A1 is accessed inside the same package, another class inside the same package, also another class inside the another package. So we can say that, so public members can be accessed 1, 2, 3 within the same class, in another class in the same package, and in another class in another package, right? So that's what the public members is. So to understand private members or the accessibility of private members, we need to learn inheritance first, right? So that we will see shortly. Inheritance. Okay, so let's see. This is for protected members. So protected members, in order to learn protected members, we need to see inheritance. So protected members will be seen in inheritance. So private member will see. So in case if I have a member as a private here, so private, okay, if I declare character C3 is a private, so I can access this member here in the same class ob dot, let's say c, let me just make it private for the java 1 class, because I've created here the java 1 class, so java 1 class object. So this C1 I'll make it as a private. So once if I make it as a private, then I can access this member, that is C1, ob.c1 is equal to, let's say C character, and I can comfortably access here. But let me just see, can I access it in Java 2? No, here it started showing error, right? So the private members can only be accessed within the same click, same class, right? And here there is no question if it is not able to access in the another class in the same package. So how it will be accessed inside the another class in another package? Okay, so let me just write it here. So private, these members can also be accessed within the same package only. Okay, so private members, these members can be accessed within the same package only, right? Not in the another package, any another package. Okay, so let's look into this protected member. To understand, as I said, to understand the protected members, we need to learn inheritance first, right? So we have a detailed session on inheritance, but just for the time being, we need to just for a time being, in order to understand this protected keyword, let me just give you a brief about the inheritance. Okay, so what is inheritance actually? Look at this. Now let me just first comment where there are errors in the program, because that will not allow us to run the another programs. Now see, I have created object of Java 1 in my inside the another class, that is Java 2. Also, you can observe the Java 1 object is created in another package as well. There is no issue of creating the object. But now observe, using this object ob1, I can only access my own data members. I cannot access the another class data members, right? So just look at this. If suppose I have a class here, let's say Java 1. Okay, suppose this is a class 1, let's say Java 1. And it has some members, so I can access using the my own object. So Java 1 ob is equal to new Java 1. So with using my object, I can access only my members, right? For example, if suppose there is a class here, let's say Java 3. Okay, so Java 3 has some members. So using this object, using this object, I cannot access the data members of Java 3. Right, so that is for sure. I can access only my members if I create my object, right? But using inheritance, we can do this, right? What we can do is we can make this as a parent of Java 1, and once it becomes a parent of Java 1, I can access its data member as well using my own object. Okay, and that is actually called as inheritance. Don't worry, we are going to have a detailed section tomorrow, and we are going to see inheritance in detail. But just for the time being, just understand, using the object of this base class, this is also called as base class, and this is a parent class. Okay, so using this class, that is base class, I can access the members of my parent class, and let's see how. Okay, so here I just have to write something here in order to say that this is my parent class. So say, you have to say like this here, in front of the class definition, extends the another class name, let's say Java 1. So in this way we can make the another class as my parent. Okay, so let's do this. So let's if suppose this is a Java 1 class, where it is, so Java 1, let me make Java 3 as my parent. So extends, let's say Java 3. Okay, so now you see, even here I can access the members of Java 3. Okay, but see, so Java 3 has integer, double character and strings. So let me just see whether whatever I have said is true or not. So let's verify. So Java 1 object is there, and let's access ob dot a3 is equal to some other value, but we cannot access it here. A3, do we have here a3? Yes. Actually, the reason is that even if I am trying to access the members of my parent, since this A3 is outside the package, so and it is a default, so I cannot access it. So to access, I'll say public. So it has to be public, right? So even though it is inherited data member, inherited class data member, I should have the accessibility also here. Accessibility will also come into picture. So outside the package, only the public members are accessible, like this. Now the error might be gone, like this, right? So whatever public members are there in the another package, those will be only accessible here. Okay, so ob dot, let's say d3. okay, and default members will not be accessible even through the inheritance as well. Okay, and private members are not at all accessible outside the class. So now you see, using inheritance, I can access only the public members for the time being. So only the public members can be accessed, right? Default members cannot be accessed. If I want to access any members inside my parent class, I need to make it public. But if I make it public, it will be visible to other classes as well. Now what I want to do is I want to access the members of my parent class, and I don't want other class to access those, right? Listen to me once again. I want to access the data members of my parent class, but I don't want to access, I don't want other members, other classes to access those members, right? So in that case, what I'll do is I'll make that data member as protected. Okay. So if I make this character C3 as protected, okay. So outside the package, other class will not access this. Okay, so let me just show you both the way. So if I make it protected character C3, so you see ob.c3 is equal to, let's suppose, some character, and it is visible to me. And if I remove this protected keyword and just look at here, so it has started showing me error, right? So either I should make C3 as public or protected. So protected is better way. Okay, so protected members are accessible within the same class and in another class in another package, but not in another class in another package, right? If it is not inherited by the base class. Fine. It will be accessible, or the protected members will be only accessible, if it is inherited by some child class, and that child class may be in the same package or in another package, right? So that's all about the protected keyword, and in the next session we are going to see the inheritance. Thank you very much.